Today we will discuss the concept of retrieving data using SQL select statement. Select statement is used to retrieve data from the database table. SQL is a structured query language. In SQL, we are using the select statement to retrieve the data from database table. When we see that we are having the database table is there, in database table we can retrieve the data to display the users. We are using the concept of select statement. In select statement we are having the different capabilities of select statement. First one, we are having the projection, selections, and third one, join. So three main capabilities: first projection, next one is the selection, third one is a join. How we can define these? First is the projections. Projection is related to retrieve the data of the specific columns or set of columns. That can be one column or more than one column. That is a projection. That we are having one large table. From that large table, if we want to display the data of only few columns, let like one or two columns or three columns, that concept is called projection. Selection, to retrieve the data based on the specific row or set of rows, specific records, that is called selection. And third one, we are having the concept of join. Join is used to retrieve the data from more than one table. Let's take an example. Let here we are having I am drawing one table over here containing the different record. Table is here, first one table is here, imply. List of columns. Now here we see that our table name is here, we see imply. Now in imply table we say we are having the different column are available. First one we say imply ID. Next one column we are having the concept of we say that name. Third one column, that is salary. Next column, this one is hard date. Next one columns we say that department or email. And large one columns we are having any, that we said that we are having the department. Okay, now here we say that we are having the different employee are here, employee ID are here. We say employee ID 1, employee ID 2, employee ID 3, and employee ID 4. Name is here Ali. name is here Ahmed. Here we are having King. And last name we see that Smith. We are having the list of the salaries. So for the salaries we say that 8,000. We are having 10,000. We have salaries here 9,000. And here we are having the 15,000. Hire date, we are using the first, we set it first Feb 011. First Feb 11, 2011. So we are just using this one. Then 10 November. We are having the 10 November 13. And some other values are there. So what is the projections? Projection is related to retrieve the data of the specific column or the set of columns. That we, if we want to retrieve the data of names and salary, only these column values, these are the two different columns. Instead of retrieving complete table data, if we want to retrieve the data of only two different columns, this one concept is called projections. What is the projection? To retrieve the specific retrieve the data of specific column, one column or more than one column, that is called projections. So here we are retrieving the data of the name and salary. Next one, we are having the selection, or we can use the concept of the selection. Selection, when we want to retrieve the data of the specific, when we want to retrieve the data of the specific row or the set of rows. Let here we want to retrieve the data of all of those employees whose first name started with A. So here first these two, if we want to retrieve the data of all of those employees whose first name is started with A, all of those employees, another example we are taking, let all of those employees whose salary are, who name is Smith, in other selection. The specific row, that is a selection. To retrieve the data of the specific row or set of rows, that is called the selection. And in join, we have to take the data from more than one table. Like here we are having the department ID 10, department ID 10, department ID 20, and 30. And second one table here we are having, that is related to the department. And department table we are having the few records are there. In department tables we see that we are having debt table is here. So we are having here debt ID, next one we say that we have a column debt name, Now we want to we are having those few records for these two. So we are having the IDs here, depth IDs here 10, depth name is here CS. Then 20, we are having the engineerings. Then we are having the department ID 30. We are having the name of this one department, let me see, that's mathematics. So if we want to display the data of name and the department name is available in the department tab. So whenever we want to retrieve the data from more than one table, for that one, to retrieve the data from more than one table, we have to use the concept of the joins. So how we can use selection, projection and join? First one, we are having the projection. How we can use the concept of the projection? So for that one, we are having the select statement, basic syntax of select statement. Or we can, the first of all, we have to in SQL, that can be SQL, NDBMS we can use, Oracle, MySQL or SQL Server or any other. So in select statement, basic syntax is, we are having the select, steric is used for all, or we can use the list of the columns separated by the comma. And then if we want to display the unique value, for that one we have to use the distinct, and then from table. How we can use it, let me check it over here. First, clear the screen, CLDSCR. To clear the screen, we have to use the command clear screen. After this one, we have to write the select statement. In select statement, we say that let me set the line size and page size. Set page size. Okay. Now we have to write check how many different, what are the different columns are there in implies table, DESC implies. So it says that we are having the different columns are there, employee ID, first name, last name, email, phone number, hire date, job ID, salaries, commission PCT, manager ID and department ID. We want to display the data of the specific column. So for that one, we have to use the select. That is not a case sensitive. We can write in any order. We are having the first names. We are having the last name. And we want to use display another salary. Table is there from employees. When we write select first name, last name, salary from employee. So these are the few columns or set of columns from the table employees. Press enter. So it displays the data of the three different columns. This one concept is called projection. If we want to display only one column data, select first names, table is there from employees. Only one column data is available. So that is called selection. So for that one, clear screen, select, we select first name, last name, and hired it, table is here from employees. All of these columns are separated by comma. It displays the data over here. This one concept is called projections. In projection, we can apply the different type of formula, arithmetic formula. What are those? We see that we are having first name and last name, and we are having the salary. We want to display increase the salary by 10%. How we can increase the salary. Salary multiplied by 0.1, that is the 10%, or 10 divided by 100, that is also the same. From employees, so what it will do, it will display the first name, last name, salary, and here increase salary value, salary multiplied by 10%, so just is 10% of the salary, right? So how we can calculate the 10% of the salary? So here it calculates the value of the 10% of the salary. If we check here, salary was 24,000, so it calculated 10% of the salary, that is 2,400, 17,000, 1,700, 9,000, just 900. But over here, column name, salary multiplied by 0.01. What is the formula over here? We are using the same over. Now, how we can replace it? By using the column alias. We can use over here the alternate names instead of using the this one. Let clear screen how. Use upper arrow key to move the previous row. Press it over here as. We see that increment, so it will display the increment over here. Now we see that we want to add with the salary also over here, so salary plus 10% of the salary, and instead of increment use it over here, new salary. It's just display the data, we are not making any change in the database, we are just displaying the data. Select statement is used to retrieve the data. So what will be happen over here, salary value plus 10% of salary will be added over here, and the new salary will be displayed, and column name will be here now, the new salary. If we are having the space in column name like this one, then we must have used double quotation marks. If we don't have a space, then no need of the double quotation marks. If you want to use it, fine, otherwise that is not necessary, and as is also optional. We can use column alias with any column from employees. Now it calculates the new salary over here. That previously salary was here 2,400, now it calculated over here salary plus salary multiplied by 0.1, and then that is added over here. Now column name is over here, new salary. We use it over here, the column alias. This one concept is called projections. In projection, we can use other like addition, subtraction, multiplication, or division formulas over here. Similarly, we can use it over here, the different type of concatenation operators to concatenate one column or more than one column values. How? We see that select first name. We want to concatenate first name and last names. So for that one, we have to use the vertical bar. These two vertical bar are used to concatenate. Now we have to use the space. So use the space, and then we are having the last name. So concatenation operator, and then use last names. So we arriving the first name, then we insert the space, and then we use it over a last name. And for this one, we have to use the alias as full name, comma, we are having the hire date. Table is there from employees. So we are displaying the two different column values, and column list are available over. This one concept is called projection, and in projection we are using the concept of alias, as well as here we use the concatenation operators. Similarly, if you want to concatenate the different columns and separated by comma, so for that one we can use it over as select first names, concatenation operator, comma, then again concatenation operator, job ID as employee with job ID, employee with job, table is here from employees. So it displays the value over here. This one is employee name, first name is here, and then job ID is here. It's these are the concept related to the projections. Thanks for watching the video.